From a college dorm room to a global platform with over 936 million daily users, social networking site Facebook has revolutionized the way we communicate online. With over 20% of the world's population logging on every month to chat, play games, and check on their businesses. And best of all, it's free. And all you have to do is sacrifice your private life to use it. Facebook is worth over $200 billion and users don't have to spend a penny. So how does it make its money? Well, when you first sign up to Facebook, you agree to its data privacy policy, which states that in addition to helping people see and find things about what you do and share, we may use the information we receive about your internal operations, including troubleshooting, data analysis, research, and service improvement. That means Facebook uses your personal information to enhance its services. Over two-thirds of Facebook's revenue comes from advertising. Based on what users do on the site, companies use that information to target you. For example, if someone regularly posts about football, they will see football adverts in the Facebook sidebar. If someone changes their status to engaged, they will see adverts for wedding dresses. It is using this and your information that has changed Facebook from a social site to a multi-billion corporation. The privacy and data protection campaigners like Max Schrems are worried that the media giant is exploiting our personal information for even more power. All other companies undergo rigorous assessments before they can use our personal data, but not Facebook. Once you agree to the terms and condition, Facebook can do whatever it wants with your personal data. In other words, Facebook can commodify our most intimate online conversations and relationships for their chance to make more money from advertisers. In 2014, Facebook gathered millions of new customers after it released its new Messenger app. To access Facebook Messenger services, users were forced to download the app whether they wanted to or not. Worse still, users had to agree to the Messenger's permissions policy, which allows the app to access your phone data, read text messages, edit files on USB storage, make phone calls, see your contacts list, and use your phone's camera. Facebook claims these new permissions exist to improve its messaging services, but just 1 year later, the company was outed for conducting mass surveillance on its users. In 2015, 25,000 people filed a lawsuit against Facebook for privacy law violation. Leading the case is privacy activist Max Schrems, who claims that the site has been illegally monitoring the online activity of its users, which is why the European Union is now urging people to leave Facebook for their own personal safety. In March 2015, the Belgian Data Protection Agency revealed that Facebook has gone one step further. Its new cookie policy means that the company has been using tracking data to secretly monitor its users' online activity, whether they are logged into Facebook or not, and even those that are not registered on the site. The EU has warned European citizens that it cannot ensure the protection of their data when it is controlled by a US internet firm. Yet millions of users around the world remain reliant on Facebook for their internet social lives. But perhaps it's about time we rethink our online activity because of our Facebook accounts.
Stay fresh and funky, my friends.